What's up, Wolfpack? My name is Paul, and you're watching Alpha Wolf Knife and Weapon Review. And if you want to be part of that Wolfpack, just hit subscribe on this, and you won't miss any of the videos. All right, now let's get right into it. What do we have here? We have the QSP Penguin. Yes, one of, if not, my favorite budget knife. Absolutely amazing. Shredded carbon on this. That's shredded carbon with a little bit of blue G10 mixed in. Look how gorgeous that knife scale is. Look at that pattern. Whew. And we have a little lanyard hole there. Look inside, looks like we have black barrel spacers and black steel liners. Okay. And we have a nice deep carry pocket clip. Goes all the way up. All the way up on there. And that is reversible. You have the two screw slots that you can attach right there. They also screw in the carbon, shredded carbon fiber. Okay. I always like when the thumb stud has little grooves in it for some added grip. Opens nicely. Now you can see that really nice stone-washed sheep's foot blade there. And that is D2. And you have some nice jimping on the blade. You can choke up pretty good. Give me a nice grip for some cutting, you know. My hand fits really well. Fits right in between the slot here. Feels great, nice ergos. I do feel the clip ever so slightly, but it's not horribly bad. I mean, it doesn't stick out too bad. Yeah, it doesn't stick up too bad. You feel it a little bit right here, not much. It's not sharp, it's rounded over. Great looking blade. Oh, I forgot to mention, it comes with these cool little stickers. Have a knife day. QSPKnife.com. Better knife, better life. Nice little penguin winking at you, huh? Oh, and look at that. A wolf. Oh, now they're talking. A wolf with a knife in its mouth. Oh, yeah. There you go. QSPKnife.com, better knife, better life. Oh, and yeah. Of course, I think I might have shown you this already, not sure. But yeah, that was my logo burned in with my X-Tool D1. And a nice black finished business card. Eventually, I'll probably be putting my Instagram on there. But yeah, that's the start of it. Came out great so far. Aluminum. Love that sound. See? Nice aluminum. Put that over in the corner. All right, let's get back to the blade. That might have been giving me the issues with the not being able to focus there. All right, so... Oh, what do we have? It is a liner lock. Little jimping spots in the liner lock there. Really nice. Yeah, I really like really like this for a lot of heavy use. It's a nice thick spine. We'll be getting into that in a second. But yeah, I mean, you could really use this knife for a lot of heavy tasks. You know, not just cutting boxes and opening letters, even though that's the majority of what we do with our knives, besides flip them once in a while and look at them and show them off. But what's a nice looking knife if you don't show it off and flip it every once in a while, you know? Yeah. All right. Oh, this thing has copper washers, by the way. Oh, and I'm going to be doing something a little different when I weigh it up. I actually got this Fusion with a Z digital pocket scale because I know a lot of you guys are probably sick of that giant package scale that I was using. But, you know, it did the job. Let's see how this one does. Real nice when I don't have to adjust my camera just to get the scale in frame. But we are having an issue here. You can't see. Yeah. Can't see the That's no good. We tried, guys. We tried. But, yeah. You can't even see it. That's no good. We'll hit it at an angle. I guess I still have to adjust it, because now we have to hit it at an angle. Not good. Oh, well. We tried, guys. Doesn't show up directly face downwards, so here we go. We have 96.6 grams on there. Not too bad. Here I was thinking I didn't have to adjust my camera, and I did have to adjust my camera due to the fact that I couldn't look down on the scale without it not showing up. So yeah, I still had to adjust my camera. Whatever, it is what it is. Maybe we'll just go back to the package scale. We tried, guys. We tried. Yeah, I guess having that huge scale, it was meant to be, I guess. All right. You know what that means when I pull out the Ditron caliper here. Oh, you got to see my face a little in there. Hey, hey. I am human. Little face reveal for you guys that think I'm an alien that does these. All right. Let's see what we have here. 3.1 keeps going down. 3.0807 millimeters. 3.07 millimeters. 06. Is it going to keep going down to zero? All right. I wanted to mention, if we can see it, which we cannot, about 25% lock up there. And we have an overall length of right at 7 inches. And a blade length of, looking at 3 inches right on the dot. Yeah, coming in at sub $40, around 39-ish. What other knife can you get carbon fiber scales that look like that? The D2 blade, proven company like that for under 40 bucks. That is a great value. You know? I mean, it's pretty decently sharp. I can shave with it. Look at that. Gross. But I shave with it pretty good. Let's see how it cuts. Oh yeah, that's pretty sharp. Pretty sharp. If it can shave, it can cut paper as well. Yeah. All right, guys. That'll just about do it for this really nice budget QSP Penguin. Really enjoyed showing that to you guys, and you have a knife day.